Can you see? When you said it, why you said it? What's the meaning? Is a bounty, is a happiness. You recognize, yes, you are the greatest, Ya Allah. You do not only give us material, and you give us all the forgiveness, and all the mercy, and all the bounty from you. By this way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He won't say, all the whole earth, I want you to know who is the greatest. Can you see it? And every Muslim on earth said Allah is the greatest for allowing the rest of the Muslims to do the Hajj. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He wants us to be bound. He wants us to be united. He loves Muslims to be united. You will find many verses about unity and many verses cursing and warning if the Muslims do not be unity. This is some of the purpose of Eid of Adha. It's a lot of bounty. A lot of bounty from Allah. Now imagine if a king is so happy. A king, he have a day and he said, this is the day I will spread all my goodness. What you should do? You go ask the king for what you want. It's a happy time. What do you think? You see? This is why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said of the meaning of whoever eliminate the night of Eid, Allah eliminate and keep his life a living heart when the time Allah kill all the hearts. Because according to some status and some report, in the end of time, Allah will kill the hearts. What's the meaning killing the heart in here? Kill the heart meaning you will be a living person, but your heart is dead. You have no vision. You have no comprehending. You cannot understand. And this is what's happening now. And the Prophet ﷺ gives us a chance. What's the chance? The chance is the night of Eid, illuminated with dhikr. Remember Allah. Illuminated with takbirat. Illuminated with getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm illuminating with reciting Quran. Illuminated with getting closer to Allah. You see? Why? If you are intelligent, using the time, Allah is so happy and so pleased. And the Prophet ﷺ said, the most beloved days to do good deed is the 9th, 10th of the 9 or 10 days of Zulhijjah, which is the ultimate day will be what? The day of Arafat. And the day of Eid is the day we show gratitude and thanks to Allah. That's why we do keep saying takbirat. And when we finish salah, it's recommended to do takbirat. And actually, according to the sunnah and habit of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he go visit the needy and go visit the relative and do everything, what he does? He go after that later on, start crying to Allah and thank Him and do takbirat. Now you see? Now, this is some of the purpose of the Eid al-Adha. What else? Also to remember and remind us of the Day of Judgment. To remind us who is the greatest. Is Allah is the greatest? Or me the greatest? My children is the greatest? My wife is the greatest? My husband is the greatest? My materialist is the greatest? Or Allah is the greatest? And He gives us the example by Ismail alayhi salam, the one the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about him, the one he should be slaughtered twice. Ismail alayhi salam should be dead twice. Why? The day Allah commanded him to take his wife Hajar and put her in the desert in a place has nobody. Her and her child. Meaning go, put them to die according to material status. Imagine, you take your wife and a child and put them in the desert alone in a place has nobody. What kind of advice is that? Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell you, I'm going to destroy them. But with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He took a situation which from us or for us is completely destruction, and what He did? He make it completely for us. You see? Similar. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Ismail alayhi salam was a young boy, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Ibrahim alayhi salam to slaughter his son, by this way twice. Twice Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching Ibrahim alayhi salam to sacrifice the most beloved thing to him at this time, which was his own son. What we learned from that, what's the purpose? The purpose for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He wanted us, this is my way of you coming toward me. Sacrifice of what you have for me. I purchase already what you have for me. And each one according to sincerity, he can say what he wants. Like for example, one person he said something amazing, which is a very small example, but it means a lot. A person sitting in a traffic light. And you ask him, why are you standing in a traffic light? He said, the rule is the rule. I have to stand in a traffic light. You ask him, why are you standing in a traffic light this time? He may be in the middle of the night, no car around. He said, I have to obey the law. And you said, subhanallah, you have to obey the law. But in the meantime, inside, maybe you're drinking, you're listening to music, you're smoking, you do everything against the rule of the main creator. Look at this. We respect the law of the man, and we obey it, and we humbly obey it, and we're not willing to obey the rule of the creator. Who is the greatest? The policeman of New York or Allah? Think. This is very simple. You know? And when we disobey the policeman and he after us, yes, please. And all of a sudden, mashallah, he becomes so humble person. Now who's the greatest? The policeman? Is Allah? No. Do we do the same to Allah when we commit sin? When we disobey Allah, we think the same? For a ticket, $50 or $70, I feel so humble and fear, especially if it's a moving violation and I can lose my license. I will be like a sheep or a goat in the front of the cop. What about if I'm a completely a sinner and I die and I go to hellfire for infinity and I will be judged in the front of Allah about every mistake and every disobeying I did? Meaning I sacrifice my relationship between me and Allah for a relationship between me and material, an idol, a statue. Because sometimes we think statue, it has to be a statue. No. Today we are worshipping a lot of statue. But we think we do not have it. No, we have it. Plenty of it. My wife can be a statue. My son can be a statue. My money can be a statue. My habit and custom can be a statue. My desire can be a statue. Anything you respect and you obey and you like above what Allah wants from you. Imagine, in Eid al-Adha, Allah do not tell you that. No. Allah is talking to the obedience people and tells them what? I want you to sacrifice what you have for me. Not even obedience. No, no, obedience, it has to be a must. It's an obligation to be in a state of obedience. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He do not want obedience. He wants extra. Give me what you love. Give me what you desire. Give me what you like. Give it to me. Why? Why Allah, I give it to you? I will make it worth your while for you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said of the meaning of whoever have a goat or a sheep to give it to Allah, Allah He take it from you and He make it grow until the day of judgment, and in the day of judgment He make it work for you. Who can do that? Imagine somebody tell you, give me a sheep, I make business for you with one sheep for 2 million years, and is honest, He never cheat you, no any problem. And who's more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What about Hajar? A woman obey her husband. What about the son who obey his father? What about that? What are we learning from that? This Eid al-Adha. Everybody sacrifice. This why Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was famous by three. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِبْرَاهِيمَ الَّذِي أَوْفَّى. وَإِبْرَاهِيمَ الَّذِي وَفَّى. Ibrahim, the one, he kept his commitment. He kept his word. In what? They said, وَفَّى بِجَسَدِهِ لِلنِّيرَانِ وَوَفَّى بِمَالِهِ لِلْضِيفَانِ ووفى بقلبه للرحمن. He sacrificed his body in the fire when he threw him. And he sacrificed his money for the guests. And he sacrificed his heart for Allah when he asked him to slaughter his own son. At this time, he was the Khalilullah. Now he is closer to Allah. Because you are belong to me. Nobody greater and greatest in your life except me. Do you know what Allah want? Allah, He want every Muslim to say it in his heart, Allah is the greatest. But you do not say it with your tongue in occasion, and inside your heart, you think about your wife, you think about your kids, you think about your money, you think about your wife, you think about your husband, you think about what you have, your car, whatever. We become a worshipper of all, everything except Allah. How you know? Very simple. See how much time you're giving to material, how much time you give it to Allah. How much is time you spend to gain what you like, and how much you spend for Allah. How much money you spend in the path of Allah and the cause for Allah, and how much money you spend for what you desire? Very simple question. Everybody knows the answer. Believe me. Nobody, believe me, is a fool. Nobody can say, I do not know. Everybody deep inside knows. What's the difference? Stingy. But what kind of stingy? Some stingy is so ugly. Imagine you do not want to go to paradise. Imagine you want to go to hellfire. Imagine you do not want to please Allah. You want to please everybody except Allah. Imagine. This is the main core of Eid al-Adha. By this way, if I really want to engage in Eid al-Adha, I ask myself, what I am doing in the night of Eid? What I should do? Dhikr. Remember Allah. A lot of takbirat, a lot of thanks to Allah, a lot of getting closer to Allah. To get what the Prophet ﷺ promised me, to have my heart alive in the time Allah kill all the heart. Meaning, have complete veils. And today, if you look to the majority of people, Muslim or non-Muslim, the heart is dead. How he knows the heart is dead? The person is not even going towards his goodness and benefit himself. What more than the person is not benefit himself? Imagine I tell you, you are in a route of hellfire, and you said, fine, fine, let me alone. Imagine. If you do that in this life, we'll call 911. He said, this man is crazy. Take him to the mental institute. But we're doing it physically every day by our action between us and Allah. And we forget, we are being accountable for every action, every day, every moment. And whatever day is gone is lost. By this way, I believe in a day of Eid, if you're not sacrificing enough, remember, I have to do more effort and sacrifice for Allah. And if I'm sacrificing, how I sacrifice more? And how, if I'm not doing it, how I cry to Allah and ask Him, oh Allah, give it to me before it's too late. Because in the moment of death, you will pay the price so heavily, if you believe it. If you believe it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even tell us, from your money, your wives, your spouse, your children is an enemy, is a trial. Don't let your wife and money and your children make you stray from what Allah wants. Do not take it as a game. You will find the Quran is full of advice about our family and what will Allah give us. Because Allah gives us as a trust. We do not own it. We do not own nothing. This is why when we lose something, we start crying. Why? Because we think we own it. But once actually we lost it, we realize the truth. But it will be too late. You see, always the son of Adam, Shaitan making us want to realize, but it's too late. By this way, this is some of the purpose of Hajj. What about the manner? People always believe the day of Eid is the day of eating, the day of happiness. Happiness of what? What are you doing to be happy about? Umar ibn Abdul Aziz radiallahu anhu, his two daughters came to him in the day of Eid and said, oh, our father, and he's the Khalifa. Imagine the Khalifa of all the Muslims. The church have no poor in his own ummah. It never happened in any time in life. He has a treasure of all the Muslims. And his two daughters are coming with dress full of holes. Holes, very, very old. And said, oh, our father, please, can we have a new dress for Zaid? What he tells them? لَيْسَ الْعِيدَ لِمَنْ لَبِسَ الْجَدِيدِ ولكن العيد لمن خاف يوم الوعيد. The day of Eid is not the one for those who dress new clothing, but the day of Eid is the people who fear the day of judgment. This is Eid. This is why you have certain duty in a day of Eid: visiting the sick, relative, join heart. Even with the people who you dislike, or you have something against them, united your heart with your relative, forgive each other for Allah, try always spread forgiveness. And what else? And also even think about the dead people, make dua for them, if you can visit them. Do you need a reward too? Look at how the beauty of Islam. Poor people, relative, neighbors, share whatever Allah give you. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us. It's almost like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell you, come, give me your dirty heart, I clean it for you. Spend, let me clean your heart from stingy, from greed. Give me, let me clean you from your dirt. Because all this disease is dirt. Look at us today. Why we fight with each other? You hardly find a Muslim family is a family. Especially if the parents die. Everybody fighting and arguing. For what? For a couple of thousand dollars? You're losing your own brotherhood and sisterhood for a couple of thousand, and even with knowledge you're not sure about it? And you allow shaitan to bubble you up for what? And all of us is not a multimillionaire. Imagine if we really are multimillionaire, we'll kill each other. And it's happening.